Welcome to the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championships presented by Northwestern Mutual. A scenic shot across the Des Moines River to Wells Fargo Arena, home of the 2015 regional final between Hawaii and two-seed Minnesota. Both squads besting Big Ten opponents in the semifinals. The Rainbow Wahine swept defending national champion Penn State. The Golden Gophers beat conference opponent Illinois. Welcome inside, Kara Capuano with former All-SEC standout for Georgia, Maria Taylor. Maria, we've got Hawaii versus Minnesota, a pair of conference champions. How do these two teams contrast?
Well, if you think about Minnesota, you're thinking about a team that's very disciplined. Everybody knows their role, and they don't ever do anything that's uncharacteristic, as in they don't hurt themselves. Hawaii, they're the scrappiest team remaining in NCAA tournament, and they're the only unseeded team remaining, and it's that relentless effort that has led them to this point.
These two teams both led by conference players of the year. How does Dolly Santana impact Minnesota?
Well, she's one of those all-around outside hitters that does absolutely everything for her squad. She had 17 kills and hit 286 against Illinois in the regional semis, and she'll be looking to get things going early from that left pin. And then Nikki Taylor, this is the player she might be matched up with depending on how the lineup shake up. And Nikki Taylor's a right side who can hit out of the back row, hits out of the front row, and plays defense. She had 18 kills and 8 digs against Penn State, and she is the go-to hitter for the Rainbow Wahine.
Both these teams last advanced to the national semifinals in 2009, which will make its triumphant return. In Iowa State Capital Des Moines for tonight's regional final. Time now to head inside the locker room. Let's take a look at how Minnesota and Hawaii are planning for success, presented by Northwestern Mutual.
I think the biggest thing, of course, with this resilience and our ability to battle. And it's phenomenal, right? And that to me shows a team that's maturing and a team that's becoming the best version of itself. So here's another chance to build on that tonight, right? Let's go. Let's have a look.
Minnesota on two.
You know the game plan, yeah? You guys have studied, you've been great. The last 2 weeks, you guys have followed it to the teeth, so let's do that. All right, let's go here. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Maria, Hawaii's emotional leader is the senior, Tai Manu-Olavau, a co-captain with setter Taylor Higgins.
And she's hitting a career-high 227 and only had one error in the matchup against Penn State. She, too, is a go-to hitter in the front row, and a lot of times it's when Nikki Taylor's in the back row.
Hannah Tapp and Paige Tapp, the two twins from Minnesota, in the middle.
Hannah Tapp, she hit 565 against Illinois, and that is her best hitting percentage of the season against a ranked opponent. She adds that dynamic that allows the pin hitters to have a little bit more breathing room when the ball's set outside.
Outstanding packed house tonight at Wells Fargo Arena. Minnesota first to serve with setter Samantha Seliger-Swenson. Dolly Santana right into the block, but blocked out of bounds. That's the kind of power behind her swings.
Very strong swing, and Dolly Santana has a very high reach and rip, but you'll see her arm swing very fast. When she gets cranking and that ball hits the ground, there's not going to be much that can stop her.
Inside set that time. Works well for the Wahine to Olivia McGill.
And middles were a big portion of the success for Hawaii in their matchup against Penn State. They wanted to establish their middles early. McGill operating with a not-so-perfect set, but she adjusts in the air to get the kill.
Setter Taylor Higgins, number 7, back to serve for Hawaii. Sometimes it's just that little trick that can set a team out of rhythm.
And you can see maybe early there's a little bit of nerves here in this matchup. Both setters working on timing with their middles, looking for that clean swing. And you might see that in the first few points of the first set.
Santana, one of the most exciting serves in America, team leader with 38 aces. That's Nikki Taylor right there.
Saying aloha from exactly. The left pin. Usually you're going to see her swinging from the right side, but she's got power. It doesn't matter exactly where she's lining up. High reach and rip. If you give her a seam, she's certainly going to take it.
Manu Oleval back to serve for the Rainbow Wahine. Tap runs into some frontline defense. Set outside now to Greeley. Couldn't get by that Golden Gopher block.
And having Hannah Tapp, that 6'2", long and lanky, great block on the right side, really helps out the Minnesota Golden Gophers set up several more blocks and stuff blocks at that.
Minnesota's libero, Dalianis Rosado back to serve now, number 17 in the different colored jersey. Well, that time Minnesota was ready for the quick set to McGill.
And that time it was Molly Lohman dropping her hand. She didn't go straight up and just try to take up the space in front of her. She dropped that hand and took away the cross-court shot, protecting her defense a little bit more. It's really good blocking out of the middle.
Lohman, the sophomore out of Mankato, Minnesota, with 7 block assists in each of Minnesota's last 2 tournament matches. Will reaches further back. Santana keeps Minnesota in the point. Rosado sends over the free ball. That's the kind of defense that we're going to see from both these teams tonight. Nobody wants to let the ball hit the floor when it's Minnesota and Hawaii.
That's right, and everyone's going to be all over the floor. Dolly Santana is really hustling here, getting all the way out of the court, keeping the ball alive. 2 free balls, and finally Hawaii comes up with the kill, going to their go-to hitter, Nikki Taylor.
Over the back of Hawaii's defense, Savannah Kahakai serving. Off the block, point Golden Gophers.
I like the decision to run 2 quicks right in front of the setter there. That causes the middle blocker for Hawaii to make a decision. You run 2 double quicks right at her and just play a guessing game as to who the setter's going to set.
Katie Shaw serving now, the junior out of Richland, Michigan for Minnesota. Excellent choice by Paige Tapp right in the middle of the net. Some reminders, basics on the college volleyball rules. Best 3 of 5 to win the match. Rally scoring each time the ball hits the ground. A point will be scored. Sets 1 through 4 are decided by 2 points at 25 or higher. And if we get to a tiebreaker deciding game 5, it's a 15-point set. Minnesota's block has come to play early.
Sarah Wilhite just camping out on Nikki Taylor right now. You see that? All 4 hands over. Wilhite finishes with her block into the court. It's a good press, but an even better finish.
A 5-1 run for the Golden Gophers has them leading 7-3. Santana from the back row gets it just inside the corner.
Having Santana playing your middle back position gives you a pipe and an opportunity for an extra hitter. And early Minnesota playing the disciplined volleyball that we expect.
Welcome back to Iowa's capital city, Des Moines. Minnesota is on a run right now, 6-1 run to take this 8-3 lead over unseeded Hawaii early in the first set of our regional finals. Katie Shaw continues to serve for the Golden Gophers across the break. The block comes through for the Rainbow Wahine.
And it looks like it went off the head of Maglio on that play, but those are the kind of blocks and opportunities that you need to fall for you. Right now, Hawaii is getting good opportunities offensively. They just keep running into that big Minnesota block.
Nikki Taylor serving now, Big West Conference Player of the Year. Service ace for Hawaii's ace leader, number 43 on the season for her.
And you see Taylor going after Wilhite, forcing her to pass and then get out, transition, and be able to swing.
Santana calling from it, from the back row. An attack error. Zarembo Wahine, 29-1, went 16-0 in the Big West to win the conference championship, presently on a 24-match win streak. They not only lead the NCAA in blocks per set, they lead in winning percentage. The Zarembo Wahine have only one loss on the season, and that came at home in five sets to UCLA September 6th, as Taylor gets another ace to shorten that Minnesota lead to only 1 point. There's a timeout on the floor, and we will take it with them. Minnesota, a 1 point edge now. It's a pretty short drive between Minneapolis, Minnesota, and Des Moines, Iowa, just 244 miles, about 3.5 hours. The Big Ten champions were the Minnesota Golden Gophers, first Big Ten title since 2002, second in team history, behind a best 18-2 finish. They had never played that well in conference, in the strongest conference, by the way, Maria, that sent 9 teams to the field of 64 this year.
And remember, Kara, this is a Minnesota team that did not make the tournament field a season ago. They went 19-12, and this is a team that really was looking forward for the opportunity to play the following season and prove exactly the type of team that they are. And only having 4 losses in conference play just goes to show the wonderful coaching job that Hugh McCutchen has done this season.
Number 2 national seed for Minnesota, its highest in program history. Nice stick there by Rosado. Really goes up high off the block. Still alive. Minnesota was celebrating momentarily. And after that, Hawaii ends up getting the point.
And that's what Hawaii does. They will frustrate you as a hitter just when you think you have a kill. Look at that. Great hustle by Kahakai. And the ball stays alive. The Zarembo Wahine are just the queens of keeping every single ball off of the ground. They will frustrate an offense quickly. Used to hate playing against teams that had such great scrappy defense.
Rosado, the outside bump to Santana, and she spied a spot where there were no Wahine waiting.
A good job by Santana, just showing how smart a senior leader can be. Sometimes it's not always about power. Sometimes it's about having a high volleyball IQ, and the roll shot was there. No defense to cover the spot.
Paige Tapp, the junior out of Stuartville, Minnesota, back to serve now. Taylor, big swing, dug up. And then Minnesota finishes with the point, but that point might belong to Alyssa Gaynor.
Yeah, and a great job getting up early. And Seliger Swenson going up, jumping with that ball, because she could have gone over on 2 because she is the front row, but she drew the block and still decided to go with the set in the middle.
Outside to Santana. Kahakai takes the second touch. Manu Olevau runs into a roof.
And it's from Hannah Tapp. You can just see her dropping that left hand, reaching back into the court. Look at her, not giving up any of the cross court. Manu Olevau, not a lot of room to work with. She was already set inside the court, and Tapp taking up a lot of space.
3-0 run for the Golden Gophers. In! Make it 4 in a row for the number 2 seed.
We've already seen Dolly Santana come with her own roll shot, and now set inside the court, it's a little bit of a deeper roll. Still looking for the open portions of that back row defense for Hawaii, and she's done a good job picking it apart.
Higgins with the back set right into the block. The Golden Gophers are on a roll.
And it's all about defense right now. You're seeing how great of a job they're doing setting up their block. Santana, she's out and ahead of the play, reaching back in and finishing her block to the court. Now, if you're a Hawaii hitter, you're going to be thinking twice about the shot that you need to hit in order to keep it out of the hands of Minnesota's block.
5 blocks for Minnesota to 1 for Hawaii, and everybody's getting in on the block party.
And we're seeing that it's all the way across the net. You see it here on the outside hitters, finishing shoulder to shoulder. Then we see the one-on-one block in the middle from Hannah Tapp, and then pushing early and often. Molly Lohman getting in from the middle block. what we've seen is every single hitter that's come into the front row taking a responsibility and a need and a want to actually reach over and take away opportunities from Hawaii. And that's what it takes to be a great blocker. You have to be disciplined, you have to stay ahead of the play, and you got to have a little bit of anticipation. It seems as though Minnesota has all of those things, which is good to see when you're playing an opponent that you rarely get to see and have had a very short time to prepare for.
Fan Sunday at 2 o'clock Eastern on ESPNU, the Men's College Cup between number 8 Stanford, number 2 Clemson, both semis decided by penalty kicks. Stanford looking for its first title, Clemson last one in 1987. Presented by Northwestern Mutual, also streaming live on Watch ESPN. The Men's College Cup, an NCAA champion, will be crowned on the men's soccer pitch. We knew that blocks were going to impact this regional final, Maria, because Hawaii came in the national leader in the blocks, over 3 a game. Minnesota 14th in the nation coming into regional weekend with 2.88 blocks per set.
Yeah, and Hawaii had 5 blocks against Penn State, and they needed every single one of them to get by and frustrate the Nittany Lions, but we also know that Minnesota does a great job staying disciplined with their block as well, having 8 against Illinois in the regional semis.
That time, 6'3 sophomore Emily Maglio looked like she just reached up and over that block to get the point.
You know, and I don't think that we've really seen a perfectly timed and hit ball out of the middle from Hawaii yet. Usually, or that was something that they really relied on in the regional semis, was getting the middles going early. But the timing just seems a little bit off, and the middles are having to make plays right now.
Santana sends a spinner off the block.
Reaching for the high hand. She's gone with 2 roll shots before, this time off of the high hands. And remember, Taylor Higgins, the smaller blocker, is up front against Santana right now.
It feels like Dolly Santana is putting on an offensive clinic, showing young players all the different ways that you can score with a high volleyball IQ and a lot of athletic skill. Point Hawaii.
That was a great turn that time down the line by Tai Manu Oleval, deciding to change up her shot. She's been blocked a couple of times trying to go cross court, so going line and having some success.
Taylor Higgins, the setter, back to serve again. Second on the team in aces this season to Taylor. Points, Rainbow Wahine.
And Nikki Taylor with a smile there. You recognize that ball's almost out, but she got up and got a huge touch on it. And you can see that Santana is looking for that block. I mean, she's hitting off the top of the high hands, looking to use the block right now.
And a tap gets it done.
Hannah Tapp, you'll see her come in. She'll play a little right side. She'll play a little middle. And when she's in the middle, you're going to see a lot of slides right over the top of the block, perfectly run, chasing down the set. And a great touch release point from Hannah Tapp.
Manu Oleval got a fingertip on it.
And that's 2 back-to-back kills for the senior. Really being utilized while she's in the front row. Now when she's in the back row, she has some of the best ball control that Hawaii has to offer on that back line.
With fellow senior Olivia McGill, the only 2 players to start every match this season. Real high dug by Kahakai. Manu Oleval from the back row. Free ball coming, and it gets over McGill into the no woman zone.
Well, you could see everyone freeze in the back row thinking that McGill was going to go over and hit it on one with that overpass, but the depth perception just a little bit off for McGill and unable to make a play there.
Net violation. For Minnesota, I didn't see it, but I heard the whistle very quickly.
Yeah, you can see the net kind of moving just a little bit. It looks like it was called against Molly Lohman as she was trying to get over and close up that block. See it again? Yeah, just going up for the block was Lohman.
Service error as Minnesota sides out. A little different than Minnesota's experience in the first set yesterday against the Illini, when they twice trailed in around this scoring differential by 6 to Illinois and ended up coming back to win that first set. are too tough.
And that's how you know you have a lot of velocity on your ball, when there's a defender in actual good defending position, but they just can't handle it. I mean, it's coming off too hard. You're unable to really get down and dig that ball. I mean, Nikki Taylor, there's a lot of pop on her balls. Now she goes into the back row, but she will remain an option for Taylor Higgins. Ahakai keeps ball up. The finish for Taylor, and that's the option that we're talking about. Even though she's back row, she's still gonna swing out of that right back position, and look, it's spread. You can see that Will Height completely forgets that Nikki Taylor is an option, is just late getting that block up on the back row attack. Minnesota gets it right back behind the swing of Will Height. And you see Kelsch was in for just that one point, trying to provide a block against Will Height. But Sarah Will Height doing a good job using the block, turning off of the high hands there to generate her kill. Taylor tried to get a little sneaky, and it didn't pan out that time. It's Big Ten Player of the Year versus Big West Player of the Year. Santana that time flexing her muscle with a little bit of hang time and recognizing that the roll shot is coming. A great play at the net.
One-handed dig by Taylor. Another one to Greeley outside. Halle Greeley, too wide, point, Golden Gophers.
Well, Hawaii doing a very good job of covering their hitters, but right now it's a difficult rotation for Hawaii. They've got Taylor Higgins, their setter, in the front row. Nikki Taylor, their go-to hitters, in the back row. If they don't have really good passes in this rotation, it's difficult to get out of.
Halle Greeley, high off the block. Nice hustle by Seliger Swenson to get that second touch and set up number one in white.
Dolly Santana just making it look easy on that left pin. I mean, the roll shot's been there, and again, she takes a little bit off of this. It's an out-of-systems play. It's a roll shot through the seam. She just has very good court vision and awareness right now at this point. And now Kalei Greeley is going to the sideline.
From McKenna Granato, number three, came in for Kalei Greeley.
And the idea there was just to add another offensive option for a passing rotation. Now Greeley's in the back row, and she's one of those players that's glue, does a little bit of everything for the team. Not going to wow you with any kind of offensive power, but doesn't make a lot of mistakes.
Very steady player and had a wonderful first and second round weekend. 16 kills against TCU, followed up by 10 kills and a 625 hitting percentage against Texas A&M. Dolly Santana continues to exert her will
in spreading the ball all over the court. We've seen it with power, but we've also seen it with a lot of touch and finesse. I mean, that ball is just a roll shot right over the block, and it was fairly closed up, just playing very, very smart and efficient volleyball right now.
8 kills hitting 500 is number one in white for Minnesota, Dolly Santana. Manu Olevau off the block to side out for Hawaii.
And the reason why Dolly Santana is so great is she's a left side hitter that's currently hitting 500 in a regional final. She's taking balls that are not perfectly set, and you have to remember that. These are out of systems balls. Sometimes they're bump set. Sometimes it's the secondary setter getting her the ball, and she's still handling it very well.
There, Bree Anderson, number four for Hawaii, serving. Hustles to get to it, but to no avail.
So now it seems like the tips are working all the way across the net. Play by Hannah Tapp, that's the quick one right behind the setter. We call that a six. And that sets up set point for Minnesota.
Samantha Seliger Swenson, the freshman out of Minnetonka, Minnesota, at set point, set one. Manu Olevau keeps Hawaii in the set.
A little bit of power, that's what you need. Now you're gonna need a whole lot of defense in order to maintain the serve and keep Minnesota from taking set one.
One of your best servers. Taylor Higgins bringing it in for the Rainbow Wahine. Gets us the tape. Tap goes strong. And that will be the exclamation point on set one for two seed Minnesota, taking it 25-18.
Very impressed with the discipline that we saw out of Minnesota, but especially the play of Dolly Santana making it happen with all of the tools in her toolbox on that left side.
Welcome back to the Des Moines Regional Final. Kara Capuano and Maria Taylor with you. Minnesota has taken set one from Hawaii, 25-18, led by the power of the Big Ten Player of the Year, number one in white, Dolly Santana.
8 kills, only 2 errors on 12 total attacks. She's hitting 500 right now and mixing up every single one of her shots. You just don't know what to expect, and she's very deceptive. She's not showing her tip until very late in her swing. And you know, Kara, I saw Dolly Santana last year when I was calling a regional in Minnesota. I actually had to ask her, where is the gym? And she was sitting it out. She had her big coat on. Her team wasn't playing in the NCAA tournament. And it seems as though she's here right now to prove a point, to help her team get to Omaha and play in that national semifinal.
Hitting percentage, a big disparity in Minnesota's favor as well. The Golden Gophers menaces with 6 blocks in the first set.
And it seemed as though they just were well ahead of the game when it came to the offense that Hawaii was attempting to run. There was just no open space, no breathing room for the Rainbow Wahine to work with. And now that they've seen it, you'll see what kind of adjustments Dave Shoji has made with his team and his offense in the second set.
Taylor Higgins serving for the Rainbow Wahine. Service error to start the second set for Hawaii. Minnesota finished that first set on a 7-3 run. At this level, Maria, the concept of siding out with your opponent, keeping those runs as minute as possible, how difficult is it when they're this elite service ace, Dolly Santana?
It's very difficult, especially if you're just trying to defend your serve or come up with a good pass. You've seen how great the serving is. Dolly Santana with the jump float, we've seen Nikki Taylor's jump spin, and a lot of it comes down to how well can you receive and everyone bettering the ball with every single touch.
Very tight to the net for Higgins. Nice recovery. Set outside to Wilhite. Hawaii can't dig that one. Great contact by number 8 in white.
And it was a very well-run offense on that play. Wilhite getting up with a quicker tempo, and there was also a double quick run. We saw Molly Lohman running a quick in front of the setter as well, which can be deceptive if you're a blocker trying to decide who you want to go up and block.
Side to Wilhite. One-handed save by Higgins. Nice attempt by Molly Roman to get it to the back row. No avail, so she says, all right.
The solid shoulder-to-shoulder block, but it started with Hawaii putting in a lot of hustle. I mean, you have to get Higgins her credit for getting that one-arm dig, but then you also have to give credit to the huge block. Wilhite getting shoulder to shoulder with Molly Lohman, a stuffed block with the answer.
Santana continues to serve, but ends her own run with the service error. It's 4-1, Minnesota. Santana, the senior out of Corozal, Puerto Rico, part of the Puerto Rican national team. As Manu Oleval, the senior serving now for Hawaii. Set to Hannah Taft. She has had a real confidence and swagger this weekend specifically. She came with a special new edge to her.
Yes, as if no one can slow down Hannah Taft. Great finish. The double block was there. She's just hitting the ball at a very, very high contact and coming off a day where you hit 565 against Illinois. I mean, she's feeling really good and confident right now.
I feel pretty good about 565. Olivia McGill connects for a kill for the Rainbow Wahine.
And I think Hawaii needs to see more of that. Their middles getting good contacts on the ball with great timing in the middle, because what we've seen are stuff blocks coming on the pins. We're seeing that Minnesota is doing a really good job of getting outside, but if Hawaii can get their middles going, it'll put a little more stress on the defense.
Seliger Swinson goes over on 2. Hawaii responds. Wilhite with another tip. Free ball. Taylor outside into the Minnesota block. Point Golden Gophers.
And there's the stuff block we were just talking about on the pins. You're seeing all four hands over, shoulder to shoulder here. Molly Lohman, what a great finish. The swing block is there right on time. Will Hyde, I think, got most of it, but it's just shored up with the great lateral movement that we're seeing out of the Minnesota middles.
A pair of Minnesotans at the front there. Lohman out of Mankato, Will Hyde out of Eden Prairie. 9 players from Minnesota on the Golden Gophers roster. 7 players from the state of Hawaii on the Rainbow Wahine roster. And you gotta love the idea of these young players being able to stay in their home states and represent. Double contact called against Hawaii there.
And when you have such great programs at home, if you're in the state of Minnesota, why wouldn't you go and be a Golden Gopher? And if you're in Hawaii, Dave Shoji said it, he has players contacting him that really want to be a part of the program because that's what they've grown up watching.
Taylor gets it done, gets through the block, and just nobody to back up that front line.
And Nikki Taylor should do more of that, especially when she sees the double block is there. Why not use the high hand, turn it a little bit more down the line? When you're going up a big, strong, tall block, you're gonna have to hit the top and use a little bit more than you're used to.
Service error for Taylor. Led the Big West Conference in points per set, kills per set, and aces per set, but the high reward serve sometimes comes with high risk. Will Hyde serving now for Minnesota. Taylor. Cross to wide. Rainbow Wahine have called a timeout. We will take the timeout with him. Minnesota by 9 in set 2 of 1-0. Volleyball fans, make ESPNW.com your online home for the NCAA volleyball postseason. Some of this week's story, 5 things you need to know, written by Michelle Vogel heading into the regional round. The player of the year spotlighted, that's USC's Samantha Bricio. And a wonderful piece on celebrations. One of my favorite things about watching these matches in person is just the spirit and the energy and the enthusiasm. Every point is precious to earn and deserves the celebration.
And that's how you generate your own energy. And Hawaii's looking to do that right now. They're going to have to celebrate hard when they do come up with a point.
Instead, it's the large Minnesota contingency brought to its feet by that Santana kill.
Dolly Santana moving in a little bit. She likes the quicker tempo. If you're watching Dolly play for the first time, what you're noticing is that the ball is coming at a lower trajectory. It's going to come a lot faster to her. She's an outside pin hitter that likes to have tempo on her sets.
Back set to Paige Taft. Kahakai is there. Now Taylor gets a shot at it. Taylor just sends it over. One-handed set there by Maglio to keep Hawaii at the point. From the back row, Will Hyde finishes.
Well, that's what you get when you have your outside hitters remaining in the back row and playing all 6 rotations or having an opportunity to swing out of the back row. Will Hyde calling for that pipe. She really wanted to be involved in the play, and that's a great finish out of the back row.
The Golden Gophers continue their run. Different serving styles in display here in the regional final. Elite service is the name of the game. And finally, a much-needed side out for Hawaii behind Emily Maglio.
And Emily Maglio, she's one of those players that is a go-to, just a sophomore, but she's come on strong this season for Hawaii. One of the reasons why they were able to go undefeated in conference play, and Dave Shoji said that she was one of those question marks coming into the season, but she's really showing her true colors and her ability to play from that middle position.
Played sparingly in 14 matches as a freshman last year, but the sophomore out of British Columbia, Canada. I was talking about 7 Hawaiians on the Rainbow Wahine roster, but he mentioned, and you brought it up shortly, and then we got distracted by yet another exciting point. A lot of players that play for Hawaii, if they're not from Hawaii, they have some sort of a connection to the state. Perhaps they have ancestry, maybe they're related to people that live there. Golden Gophers take back the momentum.
Well, it seems like the Golden Gophers have had an answer for every single play that Hawaii has come up with. And that time, getting involved is Paige Tapp. That's the twin sister of Hannah Tapp. And it's Paige Tapp back to serve. Paige Tapp's number 4 in white, twin sister Hannah, number 7. They are identical, though Paige's hair is a little bit lighter. Santana, high off the block. She just has so many tricky tools available as the offensive clinic continues from number 1.
Yeah, and your hat really goes off to the great dig that came before that swing by Paige Tapp, playing her one rotation of back row. She goes back and serves. She steps in there as a middle blocker and gets a nice dig, setting up Dolly Santana.
Service error for Paige Tapp as she steps out. And Dalian Liz Rosado, also from Puerto Rico, a different part of Puerto Rico than Dolly. Dolly's from Corozal. Dalian Liz Rosado from Morovis. Hugh McCutcheon, he's a New Zealander in his fourth year at the helm of Minnesota. A little international flavor up there in Minneapolis. Nice job by Gaynor to keep Minnesota in this one. Santana sends over the free ball. Great decision by sophomore Kendra Kalsch. Sparingly comes in to help for Taylor Higgins in the setting role.
Well, I like the decision to leave Kalsch in a little bit longer. She brings you some more size, and now she's going over on 2, generating a little bit of offense there with that 6-1 size.
24th kill of the season for Kalsch. Santana gets it right back for Minnesota.
I absolutely love what the announcer just said. Welcome to Dollywood.
I'm laughing on right now.
The cross-court shot is there. We've seen her do it with some off-speed shots, but do not forget that Dolly Santana also has a vicious swing. She can put all the velocity on the ball that anyone in the nation possibly could.
She had 39 kills on 93 attacks in a match against Louisville on September 4th. 39 kills in a match. Dig by Dalian Liz Rosado. Again, it was Santana trying to place it, and that time, nobody's perfect.
Right, exactly. It's still hitting a very high percentage right now. It's very efficient, but you see her mind always working, thinking about what is the open spot on the other side of the court, and can I thread the needle? Can I get the ball there? That's what the senior is always going through every time she goes up to swing.
15th in the NCAA in kills percent and 19th in points percent by Santana. And really, it's the balance of Minnesota that we saw last night in the semifinals that's continuing today.
Very impressed with the way that Seliger Swenson just spreads this ball out. I mean, she is giving her hitters one-on-one opportunities all over the net, and it's because of her excellent decision-making. Only a freshman setter has come in, set this team to a Big Ten championship, and is now trying to help them advance on in the NCAA tournament.
Santana already with 11 kills in the match. Nice hands, partner. As usual, I'm leaning away, and you're reaching out to touch the volleyball.
I'm protecting everyone.
Yeah, well, I appreciate it. Protect me, please. 16-8 Minnesota advantage now in set 2. Service error, side out Rainbow Wahine. The great thing about Hawaii is we know that this team can go on runs. When they have been solid, they've been dominant. 29 wins on the season, 18 coming by sweeps, including last night against back-to-back defending national champion Penn State.
Yeah, and it never really looked like the Nittany Lions were in it. I mean, Hawaii was just dominant from the very beginning. Whether it was the way that they were scrapping out defensively, I thought that their ball control was certainly on point. And they had their way offensively. They were able to find ways to get one-on-one blocks. They just executed so well. Right now, Nikki Taylor is in the front row. It's an opportunity for setter Taylor Higgins to get the Big West Player of the Year going again.
So they go outside to Kalei Greeley. Timeout. Dave Shoji, the Hall of Fame coach, wants to talk to his team about it. We'll be right back. I guess Matt Schick was listening to our public address announcer here in Wells Fargo Arena. Welcome to Dolly World. Yes, Matt, right now it is Dolly's world, and we're all just living in it. And her Puerto Rican teammate, Dalian Liz Rosado, continues to serve. Santana.
Santana from the back row. Yeah, there it is. And that was against a triple block. I mean, Hawaii had the block up that they wanted. They read it. You could see that they all knew that it was going back row to Dolly Santana. But still, Dolly with the short roll, able to use that top of the block. Good shot by Kahakai. McGill goes with the short shot. A winner. Still haven't seen the clean contact and swings that we saw at the middle from Hawaii when they played against Penn State last night. But good to see McGill getting the kill. At this point, I think for Hawaii, at least offensively, it's about building some confidence, just feeling good about what you're doing and that you can generate a kill.
Right now, it's just the Golden Gophers kind of having their way. Success in so many different ways.
And that's the balance that Minnesota has been playing with the entire season. That time, it's Molly Lohman. It's not perfect. She adjusts mid-air and still comes up with a kill. Playing with the high efficiency, we talked about the discipline that Minnesota plays with. They just don't beat themselves.
Katie Shaw to Seligo Swenson. Santana from the back row. Great dig by Kahakai. Rosado there. Hype with another opportunity. It's a good try by Taylor, but Will High had other ideas. Finally, the Rainbow Wahine come up with another hard-fought point. We knew long rallies would be the way of the evening.
And I think that this just goes to show really the match in general. Hawaii has had to work a lot harder to generate kills. I mean, it took a long rally, a lot of effort, a lot of energy for them to come up with that one kill. Where Minnesota, usually if it's a clean pass, what we've seen is the ball's been better and the open spot and the kill has been there for the Golden Gophers.
That attempt to keep Hawaii in the point goes out of bounds. Nice work by Paige Tapp in the corner to befuddle the Wahine defense.
And can't say it enough, just what a great match right now that Samantha Seliger-Swenson is setting up for the Minnesota Golden Gophers. I mean, she is being a great quarterback right now, putting every single hitter in a position where they could be successful.
Maglio gets it done for the Rainbows.
Emily Maglio, what she adds is that high contact point. She has a lot of height on her side, 6'3", middle blocker. Like to see even more slides maybe out of her, get it in that quick tempo, but stretching the Minnesota defense, seeing if you can get a one-on-one blocking situation.
Kenna Granado back to serve for Hawaii. Unfortunate incident for her. The freshman out of Kailua Oahu into the Punahou School.
And she's in right now for Kalei Greeley. So Dave Shoji making some changes to his lineup, looking to see if he can find the answer with Kelshin, et cetera, as well.
Manu Olivao runs into the roof.
Yes. The roof is on fire for Minnesota. I mean, they have had some great reach back in, take away a little bit more space. That time, it's Hannah Tapp, and you see her block on the right side as well, but she's just as effective in the middle, dropping that left hand and taking up the cross court.
10 blocks now for Minnesota in this match. Just as I say that, they add another. 11.
All the way across the net. It doesn't matter who is front row right now. Dolly Santana, you were used to her being that offensive strike man, but she's also got a great block. And now, set point.
Nice job by Nikki Taylor.
Well, that could be some of that confidence builder that Nikki Taylor needs right now in the match. And good swing down the line, taking what the defense gives you. Minnesota's not giving up very much, but that time, Taylor getting the best of the Golden Gophers.
Second set point for Minnesota. And Hannah Tapp, with authority, puts Minnesota up 2-0 against Hawaii. For the number two seed, showing us how they won the Big Ten Conference this year. Very complete match. Let's send it now to the studio with Matt Schick and Elle Fortner. welcome you back to the NCAA Volleyball Championships presented by Northwestern Mutual. Des Moines, Iowa, host of one of this year's four regional sites, and in the regional finals, it's presently two-seed Minnesota with a 2-0 lead over Hawaii as we get you ready for set three. Kara Capuano and former Georgia offensive standout Maria Taylor back with you now. And boy, Minnesota just came out dominant in so many different facets. And just a reminder to the fans at home, this is how they won the Big Ten Conference, the strongest conference in the nation this year.
They're just playing complimentary volleyball. You're seeing them step back to the service line with great serves. You're seeing their impact player, Dolly Santana, show up and show out. We called it Dolly's World. That's exactly what it was through the first two sets. 12 kills, hitting 429. She also adds in four digs. And she's been a block menace in the front row as well. So Dolly Santana's done very, very well, and Nikki Taylor was the other impact player that we highlighted. But so far, Minnesota's done a good job holding, waiting, and pressing every single time that Taylor goes up to hit. Right now, she's hitting 087, does have eight kills, but it hasn't come easy at all for Nikki Taylor. We've seen both of these players trying to lead their teams. Right now, Dolly Santana having more success and a higher efficiency for Minnesota.
The contrast in the hitting percentage really puts a period on your comment there, but Rainbow Wahine starting strong here in set three.
And you see right now that Granado's still in. Usually Kalei Greeley is that other outside hitter for Hawaii, but Dave shows you changing up his lineup, trying to find what piece might give a spark off the bench.
Service error. Nikki Taylor just missed on that one. Santana back to serve for the Golden Gophers. Taylor goes up strong. Back set to hand attack. Kai is there, but the second ball falls to the ground as the freshman Granado was waiting for Higgins to get to it.
And that's what you get when you put someone from the bench onto the court. The team chemistry that you worked on all season long might not be perfect, and really Maglio could have gone for it. You also saw Granado who could have gone for it, but it was a great up and dig and an opportunity really for Hawaii to have a great scramble play.
Santana serving. Saved by Taylor. As Manu Olevau sends over the free ball. Hannah Tapp crushes it.
Hannah Tapp chasing down the set here. Perfect footwork. You see just a quick 1-2 step, recognizing, okay, I've got a lot of line to work with. I'm going to use it, challenging Kahakai down the line, and really just too much velocity on that ball to handle.
When we spoke with Dolly Santana on the four-team practice day, she revealed something that was fairly scary to me for the Minnesota fans at home. She almost played her collegiate volleyball at Arkansas for Puerto Rican national coach Robert Pelissa. Point Hawaii.
And now we see Emily Maglio. We talked about the middle getting going. That's McGill and Maglio. Finally, we see a little bit more of some pop on the ball coming out of the middle. That's the timing that we've been looking for Hawaii through the first two sets.
Granado back to serve. Will Hite. Higgins knew that that was going to be just too close to the net, and that kind of reveals that she is an undersized setter.
Yeah, right now Taylor Higgins coming in at 5'9". She's going up and trying to get a ball from 6'1", Sarah Wilhite, but you can see the height differential there, and Sarah Wilhite winning that one.
Rosado back to serve now. And to finish the Dolly Santana story, it was her mom who encouraged her to take the visit to Minnesota. Santana said she visited Minneapolis, got to be around the team, and knew that that was her volleyball home.
Because moms always know best.
You gotta kids, listen on to your parents. I promise. Maria and I have learned time and again that moms do know best. Savannah Kahakai's mom, on the other hand, number 15 for Hawaii, about to serve. She wanted her to go off the islands, perhaps experience volleyball somewhere else. But it was always Kahakai's dream to play for the Rainbow Wahine. McGill in the middle.
When Hawaii is having success, that's what it looks like. Olivia McGill in the center.
It is, and so we saw Maglio have some success with the kill early in the third set. Now Olivia McGill getting off to a quick start. The 6-1 senior adding in a little bit of good timing with her setter, Taylor Higgins.
So it's Monica Leval outside, no touch, point Minnesota. Junior Katie Shaw back to serve now, one of four iron women on Minnesota's team, along with Santana, Dalian Lise Rosado, and Paige Tad, the only players to play in every set this season for the Golden Gophers. Gill just hits the back line.
And this time going with the three ball for McGill. That's just about 3 feet away from your setter. A nice set that time coming out of Taylor Higgins, forcing Minnesota's blockers to move around a little bit. Can't run plays right at them because we saw what happened when you do that.
Service ace, Taylor Higgins.
And there's a little bit of energy. That's the confidence that you need if you're Hawaii right now and you're down two sets. You really want to use this juice that they're generating in the third.
Page tap. Plays one down.
Paige Tapp has really come along here. All Big Ten honorable mention. You see the swing there coming off of the slide hit.
All right, serving for Minnesota. Short set by Seliger Swenson, dug by Kahakai. Taylor terminates.
I like to call that the money spot because there's usually no defender digging inside of the 10-foot line. That sharp of a cross-court angle. Rosado doesn't even make a move for it. She sees the double block. Nikki Taylor making some adjustments here in the third set. She was blocked several times through the first two, but she's made some changes to her offensive game.
Hawaii enjoying its second lead of the match and building on it with the block.
And there's McKenna Granado coming in. Remember, she's the spark off of the bench. Paige Tapp trying to go with the roll shot, but the hang time in favor of Hawaii.
Granado was the high school state player of the year last year as a senior in high school for the Punahou School. Santana into the block. Out of bounds. Saw that happen in the first set as well. She just hits it so hard that it soars off the block.
Yes, that's a lot of power coming off of the arm for Santana, and she's always hitting into the top of the block. I mean, she's looking to use. Rarely do you see her get roofed straight down.
Higgins with the back set to Taylor. McGill. Nice save by Seliger Swenson and Santana with the finish.
Great work by Katie Shaw. I mean, secondary setter has to step in here because Samantha Seliger Swenson takes the first ball. Watch this go set. Still the quick tempo that Dolly Santana likes to hit. Not a lot of height on that, and she's still able to find her seam.
Shaw had 9 digs, third on the team, and 3 assists in the victory against Illinois in the regional semifinals. Work by Gaynor there to keep the ball off the floor. Points, Rainbow Wahine.
That's the block that Hawaii's been looking for this entire match. Olivia McGill getting out, finishing the block, closing back in against Dolly Santana. That's one of the rare blocks that we've seen against the Big Ten Player of the Year.
Claire Marie Anderson serving now, the sophomore out of the Punahou School. There are 4 players from the Punahou School on this Rainbow Wahine squad. First time they've had 4 players from the same school, one in each class. Higgins with the back set to Taylor. Cross court, too wide. Attack error.
Nikki Taylor looking for the same spot that she found on the outside. Check out the hustle play from Minnesota, just having to keep that ball alive. But the swing, it was close, but just wide for Nikki Taylor.
Katie Shaw has done a lot of yeoman's work in that back row, especially in this third set.
Olivao. Nice job by Maglio to keep her composure at the net and set up that opportunity for her teammate, Taylor.
And that's a little bit of release of some of the frustration maybe after hitting the last ball out. Nikki Taylor not leaving any room for questions. Let's go straight down the line. Rosado, I'm not giving you a chance to dig the ball either. Exclamation point before she heads to the back line to serve.
Taylor's older brother, Josh, two-time All-American volleyball player at Pepperdine. It's all in the family. She didn't start playing volleyball until she was in high school. Just a pure athlete with a high volleyball IQ to complement it now.
And you would never know that that was the case. But you see they're getting up strong out of the back row. Looks like she's attacking from the front row. You got to put two blockers up against her, challenging Samantha Seliger-Swenson to make a play.
Nice pass by Santana. Heady choice.
Out of the freshman setter, going up, recognizing she hasn't gone over on two very much in this match. I think I'll just test the well. Let's just test the sweet spot of the defense and see what we got going, and it works out.
Seliger Swenson's mom, Vicky, was her high school coach at Hopkins High, and Vicky played her college volleyball just up the road at Iowa State. Higgins counters going over on two.
Look at the setters trading points a little bit. Operating so that their offense can stay running. A good decision by Taylor Higgins. That's a very tight ball, and Higgins doesn't get very many opportunities to go over on two. It's only a 5-9 setter in the front row.
Service error for McKenna Granado. Four newcomers to this Hawaii team, including the 6-foot Granado, make this the tallest Rainbow Wahine team that Dave Shoji has ever enjoyed in his Hall of Fame career. Got a freshman, Natasha Burns, who hasn't played yet this year, that's 6'5". She'll be making an impact next year for the Rainbow Wahine. What a save by Will Height. Taylor from a tough position. It would have been hard to get past Minnesota.
That's right. It was a secondary setter that had to step in, but it starts with Minnesota and Will Height. Look at this perfect pancake dig. I mean, gets it just in time to keep the ball alive. Kahakai has to be the secondary setter, and a good job stepping in and coming up with the block is Molly Lohman.
Tied at 12s now. Rosado serving for Minnesota. Higgins on two.
Well, if you're not going to jump with the setter, and front row blockers are always supposed to stay aware and say that there's two hitters up, the setter's front row, you got to stay in shade in front of her. That means always be in her vision there. But no one's thinking that Taylor Higgins is an offensive threat.
Taylor Higgins is thinking that. Back set to cage tap. High off the block, point Golden Gophers.
Page Tap getting a lot of work in, working through or around the entire net, this time getting an opportunity to swing on that right side. Page and Hannah Tapp are very dynamic in the fact that they can swing from the right front and in the middle and run quicks all across the line.
Nice one-handed dig by Kahakai, and the finishing touch, Taylor.
And Nikki Taylor points straight at Kahakai because that's the dig that sets up an opportunity for her to get the kill. One-handed dig out of the libero. Quick hands by Taylor Higgins, and a good decision to go with that line shot is Nikki Taylor.
Service error gives us the sixth tie of this third set between Hawaii and Minnesota. Remember, in Women's College Volleyball, first to three victories wins the match. Minnesota leading 2-1. Hawaii coming out of the intermission looking to stay alive in this match. Taylor outside. Got it. There's a timeout on the floor with Hawaii leading by one, and we will take it with them. Come on back. Our coverage of the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship continues with the national semifinals. It starts Thursday, December 17th, 7 o'clock Eastern on ESPN2. For more information on the NCAA Women's Volleyball Championship, visit NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. One team has already advanced. Oh, you think the fans in Omaha are fired up?
What a
treat. Four-seed Nebraska. Listen, Nebraska travels anyway, but if they only have to go down the block to support Nebraska, watch out, everybody. Filling out the field.
Dinner across from two ladies who thought that Nebraska was going to be in the Des Moines regional. They bought tickets last year because that's how big of fans that the Cornhuskers really had followed.
Santana with the finish. But kudos to them for showing up here in Des Moines. And we've got great support not only from the Hawaii fans that traveled, the band and the cheerleaders. The players for Hawaii didn't even know that their band and cheerleaders were going to be here for the regional round. They walked into Wells Fargo Arena thrilled to see the spirited support. There's the band. They've been very active. Minnesota brought Goldie the Gopher. He's doing his part, but Hawaii has its cheerleaders.
And they've been running up and down the stairs, keeping the fans hype.
They've been very energetic. They've traveled well, and then obviously Minnesota, just a 3.5-hour drive, has traveled in a lot of Golden Gopher faithful as well. Nice pancake. Did it go out of the outside the antenna there?
Unable to keep it alive on that play, but the hustle, we're seeing it on both sides of the court right now. Pancake dig, the one-handed dig, they're starting to pay off. Anticipation, and when you don't have that, a little bit of heart will help you keep the ball up.
Both these teams last visited the national semifinal stage in 2009 in Tampa, Florida. They both fell in the national semifinals. Hawaii to Penn State, who eventually beat Texas in the Rainbow Wahine side out.
Nikki Taylor really warmed up here in the third set. Good swing. The double block is there, but she cuts it cross court.
Taylor with 14 kills to lead Hawaii. So got two service aces to complement that. Gets it over. Nice job by Taylor to keep the Rainbow Wahine in the point, but that one gets pushed just beyond the defense's reach.
And what a smart decision that time, just keeping a heads-up play, recognizing that maybe the timing's not there, it's not going to be a perfectly set ball, so Hannah Tapp goes with that deep tip, pushing it down the line. That makes a middle back defender have to run all the way through the baseline to try and make a play.
Santana serving for Minnesota. Outside to Dorado. She took a running approach on that swing. She wanted a point there. You could sense it, Maria.
I love that Granado's coming off of the bench. She's only a freshman, and she is making plays right now. I mean, she's not showing any fear. She's had to come in and pass. I see that Minnesota is really trying to get the ball in her hands on the first contact, but no fear here. She's had to step right in for Kalei Greeley.
We mentioned her roots to the Punahou School, probably the most famous alum of the Punahou School. Our nation's president, Barack Obama, class of 1979, as the Golden Gophers tie it up again.
Another good swing by Hannah Tapp coming out. That right side attack, you see she gets deep, well beyond the 10-foot line, using the block again. So much success Hannah Tapp is having, especially in swinging on the right side.
Side out Wahine. She's been a little bit quiet, the senior leader for the Rainbow Wahine.
You're right, and she had 14 kills against Penn State, and Manu Oleval was someone who would come in the front row when Nikki Taylor was in the back row, and she kind of had the answer, the kind of balance that Hawaii needed. But to see her kind of getting some good swings, warming up here in the third, you can just tell that the confidence is really back for Hawaii and their offensive attackers.
Val, a little out of position to get too much swing on it. It's passed by Taylor. Self setting at this point. Precision placement by Hawaii's four-year senior.
And a good set by Kelsch coming off the bench, providing a little bit more size. Tempo is what she's adding to the play, and a great swing by Tai Manu Oleval, making the play as a senior for Hawaii.
Welcome back to the NCAA Volleyball Championships presented by Northwestern Mutual. The Capitol Building in Des Moines, I say, one of the prettiest in the nation in men's college basketball when we're talking top 25. That's pretty good looking, too. Next Saturday, Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers pits Coach K and number 8 Duke against a number 25 Utah Utes at Madison Square Garden, noon Eastern, in a journey to the tourney game presented by Tonic. Also streaming live on Watch ESPN. Short serve by Kahakai to try to get Minnesota out of system. McGill takes the free ball but sends it just too far.
And that's a lucky play for Minnesota. They all looked and watched that inline very, very closely. And that opportunity for McGill, she knew exactly where she wanted to go with it. She wanted to go deep and see if she could paint that inline.
Very close call. Excellent job by our officials tonight, led by our first official, Brian Himmelgarn, on the ladder. Taylor outside. Nice dig by Rosado. Wilhite rolls it down the front of the block.
Wilhite going up against Taylor Higgins, the 5'9 setter. It's a matchup that you're going to like every single day of the week if you're Minnesota. And really just the finish not there, the press over the net that you need to keep the ball on Minnesota's side going up against a very strong attack.
20-20 right now. We have seen multiple ties in this set. Hawaii has really found balance since the intermission, Maria.
Well, you're right, Kara. They were hitting 085 coming out after the second set, but it seems like they found their rhythm. Nikki Taylor on the outside. We've seen Olivia McGill getting involved. And then we saw Taylor Higgins taking things into her own hands, going over on two. All in all, it seems as though Hawaii has found that chemistry on offense that they were in search of in the first two sets. The confidence is back. You recognize we're not going to get blocked every time if we spread the ball out. Taylor Higgins doing a really good job of building the offense.
Big West Coach of the Year, Dave Shoji. He's a man of many talents. He not only leads this Rainbow Wahine squad, he drives them too.
I'm just the bus driver. I got to go take the van. I'll be back.
Coach Shoji brought over a bunch of the assistant coaches. There's associate head coach Jeff Hall giving you the shaka there. And then decided he'd go park the van that he drove over. That is
a
man of all trades.
Across the street, walked across the street. I mean, it's cool. I've got, you know, second most NCAA Division I women's volleyball wins and winning percentage. But I'll park the van if you need me to. He just does it all.
1,179 career Division I wins, second only to Russ Rose of Penn State, and a career winning percentage, 85.6%. Nice save by Wilhite. Well executed when Calamity struck, and then Hawaii could not counter.
There's that timing. It's been up and down and up and down for Hawaii. Taylor Higgins looking for Olivia McGill. I think it's the right decision, though. I think McGill would have had success if that ball would have just made contact with her. But after the great play of Hawaii, that's kind of a heartbreaker.
McGill pushes it over, had just enough English and movement on it to trick Minnesota's D.
Yep, set's still a little bit low, but McGill making it work, just having to tap it over past the block, and a good decision that she has to make keeping that ball alive.
Higgins back to serve now, tied at 21. Wilhite outside, dug by Higgins. Second touch, Kahakai. Manuolevao. Santana tries to trick it over, can't get it done. I love the concentration. The look on these players' faces. Nikki Taylor with the point for Hawaii.
We saw some great defense on both sides, but it was the team that could get it to their go-to player first and in rhythm was Hawaii. Nikki Taylor coming in, not a perfect set. She was brought all the way inside, but going with the high hands.
Ahakai gets out of the way for Higgins. Manuolevao. Too wide on the cross.
and just trading points with Minnesota right now. But Manu Olivao going up, looking for that sharp cross shot. Would have been open if she could have kept it in bounds.
22-22, Maria, is the 15th tie of this third set. Outside to Taylor.
The hammer. Nikki Taylor is shining right now, and this moment, this point in the match, doesn't want the season to end here. The block is late from Paige Tapp, and that's exactly what allows Nikki Taylor to hit the scene.
Nikki Taylor had 8 kills the first 2 sets. She has 8 kills here in set 3.
She wants to keep this match alive. She's being the go-to player that we know the Big West Player of the Year can be.
McGill with the second touch to set up Granato. Santana outside. Got a defensive touch.
Dolly Santana, we haven't said her name as much, and really the Gophers haven't needed to go to her as much. The swing deep through the corner. Looks like there must have been a touch up in the front off of the block early from Hawaii.
23s now. Remember, we win by 2 in the Division I women's college game. Taylor loves it as Hawaii now has set point.
Here's the opportunity. If you get a nice serve in and you get an opportunity to play defense, Hawaii's done a really good job with their back row defense, keeping balls alive here late in the third set.
Timeout, Golden Gophers. We've talked so much about Coach Shoji and the success he's had, 41st year at the helm of Hawaii. Coach McCutcheon's success has come in a variety of different ways. Longtime coach with Team USA, both on the men's side and the women's side. The only Team USA head coach to lead both the men and the women to the podium, guiding the men's volleyball team to gold in Beijing in 08 and the women to silver in London in 2012.
And that kind of international experience that he brings, I mean, it just brings instant respect, first of all, when you show up on campus and say that this is going to be your head coach. So the team that he inherited immediately respected him. And then you see what he's been able to do within one season with this team that missed the NCAA tournament a season ago. They finished 7th in Big Ten play. They were 19-12. It was really a season that was disappointing for this team. But as a head coach, he rallied the troops. They went on a trip during March. And they were able to really come together just a little bit more. I mean, going overseas, spending more time together. He added in a freshman setter in Samantha Seliger-Swinson. And the way that he's been able to get that freshman acclimated to college and playing volleyball at the Big Ten level just goes to show what a great head coach he is.
He was the AVCA North Region Coach of the Year. Seliger-Swinson, the AVCA North Freshman of the Year. And the winner of this match will take on the winner between Texas and Florida. That's our next match tonight here on ESPNU. Nebraska has already advanced to the national semifinals. They will face the winner of our final of the 4-pack on ESPNU, top seed USC versus 9-seed Kansas. Set point Hawaii to try to push this match to a fourth set. Hannah Tapp says, not so fast.
Why tap it when you can kill it? I took that from a poster.
That's
back
right.
In the back.
The Minnesota fans brought that sign.
Yeah. Getting up again with the slide, it's worked so well for her. Really no one slowing her down from the blocking standpoint with Hawaii.
Eighteenth tie of the set at 24-24. Taylor. Cross court.
And why not feed the beast while she's hot? Nikki Taylor coming up with a huge swing. The block just a little bit late from Hannah Tapp. Now set point again for the Rainbow Wahine.
A no-go for Santana. She'll get another look at it. Kahakai sends it to the front to Kelsch. Taylor. An eruption from the Rainbow Wahine contingency in the crowd as Hawaii sends this regional final to a fourth set.
Rainbow Wahine staying alive with that relentless effort we talked about, the unseeded team for Singapore.
Welcome back to the Des Moines Regional Final. Hawaii has taken set three, Minnesota with a 2-1 lead in the match. The first two sets belong to Big Ten Player of the Year, Dolly Santana. Set three belong to Big West Player of the Year, Nikki Taylor.
You're right, Kara. Nikki Taylor now with 19 kills. Through the first two sets, she only had 8, but she really put on a show in that third set. She was showing that she can't be blocked anymore. She recognized where it was coming from. Dad is happy in the stands because his daughter's putting on a clinic in the third set. And really, Hawaii hitting 354 is fueled by Nikki Taylor. She's had to take a swing 42 times. Even Dolly Santana has only had to attack 34. She's putting the team on her back right now. No one else on Hawaii is hitting in double digits. They have to keep her going in order to keep Dad happy in the stands.
Dad Graham was a basketball player at the University of the Pacific. Mom Kimberly also in the house. Several groupings of parents are here in that cluster of Rainbow Wahine fans just behind the Taylors. The Higgins family, Taylor Higgins' mom, Dab, one of her brothers are here. Tai Manu Olevau's parents are here. The band is here. You think about the distance to Des Moines, Iowa. From Minneapolis, 244 miles. From Honolulu, 3,942 miles. And by the way, you can't drive that.
And remember, Hawaii has not been back home since starting the NCAA tournament and would not go home if they advanced to the national semis.
They are a well-traveled group. Stig by Kahakai on Wilhite's effort. Manu Olevau from the back row.
The aggression out of the back row from the senior Tai Manu Olevau. 14 kills, only one error against Penn State, and here she is coming alive out of the back row to start the fourth.
And she really was absent the first couple of sets, but had a nice complimentary role to the shining star that was Taylor in set three. Here's Taylor. Santana from the back. Maglio tools off the solo block effort from Hannah Tapp.
Perfect timing between Higgins and Maglio, and this time it's a one-on-one block situation for the middle. I didn't see that a lot in the first three sets, so Maglio taking advantage of the opportunity.
And that was actually Molly Lohman from Minnesota, bested by Maglio there. When the players get together really quickly in the huddle and you didn't quite see because you were screened out by a back row player, it's hard to identify. Talian Lise Rosado's sister, Javian Lise Rosado, is a sophomore libero at San Jose State. Their dad, Carlos Javier, started to coach them when they were very young. Didn't know anything about volleyball. Taylor with the finish for Hawaii.
She knows plenty about volleyball.
She does. So does her sister now.
Yes. On that right side, great attack. And the finish again by Nikki Taylor, picking up right where she left off. I mean, she had to just dominate the third set to help Hawaii get the win.
Taylor serving now. Stayed by Manu Olevau. And Granato gets it done.
There's the freshman again, but right now for Hawaii, you can see that the first swing for Minnesota isn't going down anymore. The defensive play is working, and Hawaii's winning that transition ball. I mean, they're playing a little bit more disciplined right now in transition while keeping the balls off of the floor defensively.
What changed for Taylor, too, Maria? We mentioned how great she was in the third set. How did she improve?
I felt like she was thinking a little bit too much, looking for the roll shots, looking for the tip shots, instead of just doing what's her game, which is hitting high balls outside and swinging away, ripping.
There was a rip there, kept alive by Seliger Swenson, but an attack error from Santana. And it was an earlier save by Kahakai that earned Hawaii that point.
That's the defensive intensity we saw from the Rainbow Wahine against the Nittany Lions, and it's paying off right now, up 4 in the fourth set.
Minnesota calls a timeout.
4-point advantage, Hawaii, biggest lead of the match so far. A champion will be crowned Sunday, 2 o'clock Eastern, right here on ESPNU. In the Men's College Cup, 8-seed Stanford versus 2-seed Clemson. Cardinal looking for their first title. Clemson last won in 1987. The Men's College Cup presented by Northwestern Mutual, also streaming live on Watch ESPN Sunday at 2 o'clock Eastern. So soccer's men's championship weekend this weekend. Volleyball's coming up next weekend for you from Omaha, Nebraska. Maglio, too far right on the cross. Hawaii making its 34th NCAA tournament appearance, 22 in a row. They've only missed one all time. 28th appearance in a regional weekend for the Rainbow Wahine, a 19th regional final. They've been to the national semis 9 times. 3 national titles, 82, 83, and 87. Right now, they'd just like to win this 4th set, Maria, and force that thrilling 5th and final set.
I'm so impressed by McKenna Granada, the freshman filling in for Kalei Greeley, only averages half a kill per set coming into this match, and she's just stepped in and showed that she has no fear as a freshman on this court.
Side to Taylor, off the tape, Santana saves it. And the other way, Honolulu. Another opportunity for the senior. One-handed save, Rosado. Will Hype. In point, Golden Gophers.
Great play by Rosado. It was a one-handed dig above her head that kept Minnesota in this. And then Will Hype, you see the one-handed dig. Will Hype coming in with the swing against the double block. The line was open. She takes a little bit of speed off of it to add some precision to that ball.
7 kills for Sarah Wilhai. Has participated in 4 blocks. Couldn't get the pancake there. Point Hawaii.
You're seeing Hawaii using the block a lot more. They're going off of the top of those high hands. They're using deflections to get their kills. 11 blocks are how many Minnesota had in the first 2 sets, but I feel as though Hawaii's made the adjustment. They want to use the block. They're not going to hit straight into it, and they're also going to just be smart hitting around the block as well.
Santana gets it through.
You can see that's a little bit of an extra long huddle for Minnesota after that Santana swing. She's talking to her team. Let's refocus right here. She's in the front row for the next 3 rotations, so we might be seeing a lot of Dolly Santana while she's in the front row.
You can hear that Ariana Grande song. Focus on. We've heard it a lot this weekend.
Yeah.
That's right.
No better time to be focusing on the senior than right now.
Hannah Tapp told us that the word that she thinks of when she thinks of this edition of the Golden Gophers is unified. Total team effort, chemistry, everything is really clicking for this team as Coach McCutcheon is perhaps questioning a substitution?
That's what it looks like. It might be talking through rotations as well. The team is out of rotation before the ball is served. It's an automatic point for the opponent. So you certainly want to be sure that your substitutions are straight. You want to make sure that you're in the right rotations and there's no question marks there.
Mary Blaylock explaining what she found from the scorer's table.
I think Kim McCutcheon wanted to make sure that he added an additional passer in the back row. Sarah Wilhite now not in the game, but she usually does play some back row for Minnesota.
Shaw and Gaynor in the back row with Paige Tapp. Nice job by Higgins. Point Golden Gophers. I like Coach McCutcheon's face just then. He gave that, like, the raised eyebrows, the stern. Keep going.
Yep.
We need a point run here.
Stay calm.
Maintain momentum. Now Santana's having a conversation with Ryan.
Good morning. Okay. No, she wasn't.
They worked that out. Every point is precious. And an invitation to the regional national semifinals is on the line. That is for context because at some point it went off somebody's shoulder or head. Is that correct?
Yeah, it looked like it went off
head.
Of the head.
Yes.
So it can play off of any body part, but you can only have three contacts going over.
That's it right there. It hit Alyssa Gaynor's head. Nice recovery by Seliger Swinson. How did that end up blocked out?
And it looked like a perfectly formed block. I mean, all four hands were over, but the finish has to be turning back into the net. If you're McGill there, you can just see the slight turn of the shoulders back out into the court. But all four hands were there, and Dolly Santana, the kind of pop that she has, you have got to be very disciplined with your blocking.
Manu Oleval trying to seize back the momentum.
And that's a good senior play.
Yes.
Manu Oleval knows that it's not going to be a perfect swing, but you know who I should attack? I should attack the setter for Minnesota. So even if she plays this ball up, then you're going to have a secondary setter step in for ball number two.
They're just so consistent, the Tap Twins. Hannah and Paige both bring something to the table.
And they're very high-efficiency hitters. You know, they don't go outside of themselves to generate kills, looking through the seam, taking exactly what the defense gives Hannah Tapp on that play.
13 kills for Hannah Tapp. She's hitting 650, has also participated in five blocks tonight of Minnesota's 12. Will Height gets it sent back, has another chance. Wow, Kahakai. Will Height again, off the blockers. Golden Gophers come up with that clawed and scratched point.
Yeah, we saw Kahakai coming in with an excellent dig, but Will Height, that's the second time that she stepped in and just said, I am ending this long rally. It was an excellent swing. We saw several times hitters trying to get in there and end it. Will Height, great job. 20 kills just yesterday against Illinois, and again here she's having a solid match for Minnesota.
Dolly Santana back to serve. Just gets it over the net and ends up sending it too far out. An out-of-bounds service error for Santana, and she's frustrated with herself.
Well, you could see that Santana was trying to aim at McKenna Granado. She's the freshman who's had to step in. They're trying to put pressure on her as a primary passer.
Kahakai serving now, the libero for Hawaii. Nice job by Seliger Swinson. Was not a great first touch, and it turns out to be a Minnesota point.
And Hannah Tapp doesn't always get to play these two-tempo balls, which is a little bit of a higher set, but this is out of system. She gets her feet to the ball and snaps a great wrist shot there.
14 kills for number 7 in white. Asada leading the way with 14 digs, the libero for Minnesota. Santana needs some help, and she'll send over the free ball. Higgins with the short set to Maglio. Pay dirt.
Maglio just with an easy shove here. Ball a little bit low yet again. But when you have a free ball, you have to find a way to get a point off of it. And running your middles is a great way to do that. Usually the defense is a little bit out of sorts on the free ball. So Maglio taking advantage.
Nikki Taylor serving for the Rainbow Wahine. Santana. I love it. An attack like that from the back row, if that's not a great demonstration of the athletic prowess of these players.
And it's a great demonstration of just how efficient Dolly Santana can be anywhere on the court. She's hitting that pipe right down the middle. There's a blocker up, and it doesn't matter. She might as well be hitting in the front row because it's the same velocity coming at you as when she's attacking at the net.
20 kills now for Minnesota's Dolly Santana, and a great play on the overpass by the front line.
Just a nice little redirection by Paige Tapp in the front row. You see the overpass, you talk, you communicate. She goes up and attacks the ball with both hands and just redirects it to her left.
Katie Shaw continues to serve for Minnesota, tied at 11. Granado knocks it by and off the blockers to side out for Hawaii.
Granado, she's not the tallest hitter,
that's out there, just 6 feet, and I think that that's being generous, but right now, using the high hands of the Minnesota block. Will Hyde. Taylor tried to keep it up, but just couldn't recover from Will Hyde. Pressure.
Yeah, and she's had a lot of success hitting down the line. Will Hyde's not going with the hardest hit ball, but really taking speed off of it to replace it with location. There's certain places that she really wants to hit at, and right now it's just down the line.
She did not want to hit that one. A service error for Sarah Wilhite. Claire Marie Anderson back to serve now, the sophomore out of Honolulu. She's the serving specialist for the Rainbow Wahine, known to spark runs. Hawaii would love to go on one here. Try to force set five against two-seed Minnesota. Santana, 21 kills, 10 digs.
And usually what Hawaii is so good at is slowing down hitters at the point of attack. They usually, if they're not getting a stuff block, they still get a good touch and pop the ball up. But against Santana, it's a little bit harder. I mean, we've seen it more than one time. She already has a double-double here with the 21 kills and 10 digs. And she's really just one of those players that can frustrate you if you're trying to be a blocker and get two hands to the ball and really get a stuff block.
H-tap, trickles it off the top of the tape. Manu Olevao.
We've seen her have a lot of success out of the back row while she's playing defense and digging and even back row attacking. That time, the double block is there, but attacking the softest part of the block, and that's the top.
To Hannah Tapp. Back set to Higgins. Dug by Gaynor. That set ranged too far away from Tapp.
Yeah, just a little bit too close to the net. It was a big stretch that time for Hannah Tapp. She's trying to make the play on the ball, but it was just so close to the net. Not much to work with there.
Devastating serve by Higgins. Nice play by Rosado. Outside to Taylor. Did it hit the blockers? Nikki Taylor thinks it did.
We'll see on the replay here, but Nikki Taylor begging for a touch on that block.
Looked like it might have been on our side of the antenna, so it was out of bounds.
Out of bounds, and it didn't look like there was a touch. The hands were a little bit late getting over to the top of the block. But right now, making sure that no one saw a touch. I mean, these are the plays and the points.
A reversal of call.
And the reason why you call over your line judge is to see if they saw a touch. You have multiple eyes watching the entire time. So Nikki Taylor gets what she wants. The serve remains with Hawaii, and a touch is called.
Could be a huge point in this match.
Absolutely.
16-13 Hawaii now. Outside to Santana. Just off of McGill's left hand.
Santana showing a lot of fire right now. If you don't like the call, then you got to go do something about it. And that time, leaving no question marks off of the block and inbounds for Dolly Santana.
Santana told us it can't just be about one player to have total team success, but when they need a clutch point or something to happen, she's the one that gets it done for them. Tap got lucky there, put just enough on it. Net violation, Minnesota.
And I think that time it's Molly Lohman going into the net on this play. Oh no, it's Hannah Tapp going over and touching at the top of the tape.
Mana Lole, Olevao serving. How does she know which side of the blocker, where to aim? How long does it take to learn that?
She's just a senior hitter that's seen just about everything. And she's going up against the Big West Player of the Year. She's going up against Nikki Taylor, who has a lot of success. Nikki Taylor averages over one block per set.
And she just hasn't had success against Dolly Santana because she's such a smart hitter who will change up her swings, who has a lot of off-speed shots and knows exactly when to use them. And we're into the block. No, out of bounds. And you can see up official signaling that ball hits the block of Sarah Wilhite.
Wilhite thought it hit Taylor, which is what I thought had happened.
See the bang bang play. We'll watch the replay again. And it does look like it hit Taylor.
They don't have replay at the NCAA regional finals. We move on. 18-15, Hawaii. Tap tries to place the push. Point Minnesota.
Well, the ball forced the line judge to move out of the way. So he said, I didn't see it. I didn't see. So your down official has to step in and make the call here. Going down the line, and that ball clearly out.
Madness in the fourth set between Hawaii and Minnesota. It's getting a little crazy in Des Moines. Donato too far across. Net violation Minnesota, which I did not see.
The last five calls have been very interesting, but the officials trying to make a call, and it looks like Molly Lohman on the way down, her elbow touches the top of the tape, and hey, good call.
Officiating crew working hard to get it right. The speed of this game, you can tell on television, but I promise you it's even more electrifying in person. And sometimes it's the slow shots that get you.
It's the roll shot. Sarah Wilhite, she's moved way off of the net, so going over the top of the block, and you can see no one ready to run through there. Everyone has designated lanes. Whenever you see a tip that you're supposed to be running through, the off blocker has a certain portion that they're supposed to cover. Middle back has a certain portion, and that time, miscommunication by Hawaii.
Nice dig by Santana. Kahakai keeps it in for Hawaii. Higgins with the back set to Taylor. Rosado one-handed dig. Higgins goes to the middle and Maglio. Nice play by Shaw. Wilhite finally drops the claw on it.
Rosado had the huge clutch dig out of the back row. The libero going to work. Look at that one-handed dig cleaning up the line. All Seliger-Swinson could do was keep it alive. And then this play, because Seliger-Swinson is up and jumping, it draws an extra blocker. So you get a one-on-one opportunity for Sarah Wilhite, who takes advantage of ending the rally.
Timeout called by Hawaii. 19-18, the Rainbow Wahine with a very slim lead. Minnesota has a 2-1 lead in the match. So if the Golden Gophers can pull it out here in set four, they will advance to the national semifinals. Coverage starts Thursday on ESPN2 at 7 o'clock Eastern. The winner of this match will be in that 7 o'clock Eastern match and facing the winner of Texas-Florida, the match that follows us here on ESPNU. Nebraska is already in the field of four. The Cornhuskers heading home to Omaha to face the winner between top seed and USC and 9-seed Kansas. And that will be the final of our four matches here on ESPNU. We have early flights, Maria. Let's just face it. We're not sleeping tonight.
We're not.
We're just going to
go five.
That's right.
We're seeing such great volleyball right now. I mean, just bang, bang, back and forth. Some tough calls that are having to be made. We're seeing some very, very elite level, high volleyball IQs, and guess who's here to watch it all? Haley Eckerman.
Yeah, sometimes the elite level player comes to watch. Haley Eckerman, the three-time first team All-American outside hitter for Texas in the house. She came over and said hello to you before the match.
Said she's back in town for playing overseas or planning to go over to Puerto Rico. Maybe she'll end up in Austin to watch her squad play, but she's spending a little time with her mom and her son. But she is one of the best outside hitters that I have ever seen play the game, Care. I saw her win the national title in 2012. It was Jarrett Elliott's first national title, and she was just lights out. One of the best players I've ever seen play the game.
Taylor from the back row, great reaction for Hawaii's star after getting that point.
And Nikki Taylor needing that one. Take her into the middle. She's taking a lot of swings out of right back. This time, they create a play so she swings out of the pipe. That's a huge play out of the timeout.
Set outside the wheel height. Tip can't get by Higgins. This time, she brings a little bit more thunder to the swing.
And Wilhite just goes over the top of the head of Taylor Higgins. Definitely a smaller blocker, the 5'9 setter. And you can see it right there, Sarah Wilhite taking advantage of that, the 6'1 junior.
Minnesota still trailing Hawaii by one here in set four. Nice dig by Rosado. Santana into the block and it reels out of bounds. Minnesota has tied it at 20s.
You see Dave Shoji made an adjustment. He said, I want a triple block up against Dolly Santana when everybody knows that it's going to her, but it doesn't matter because Dolly still comes up with the kill, hitting high and off of the block, off of the triple block.
Taylor. Attack error. 21-20. Minnesota on a 3-0 run.
Nikki Taylor has had so much success out of the back row, and she wants it so bad for her team. This time, just the contact is a little bit low and going into the tape.
Pair of conference champions. Minnesota from the Big Ten, Hawaii from the Big West. Taylor dug by Rosado. Back out to Santana.
What's extraordinary about what's happening right now is both setters are feeding the best player on the court. Nikki Taylor has taken every swing. Dolly Santana has taken every swing for Minnesota. Both teams are saying, if we're going to win this match, we know who we have to go to. And it is the go-to elite-level player at this point.
A 4-0 run for Minnesota as they inch closer to winning this regional final. Santana has been the undisputed leader of this charge.
Absolutely unstoppable. Already a double-double in this match from the back row, in the front row. We just saw her get a kill against the triple block. Really, no one has been able to flex the muscle strong enough to slow down Dolly Santana. And hitting 435, I feel like Santana's making some noise saying, okay, Samantha Bricio, I see you as possibly the National Player of the Year, but I raise you this performance. And the announcement hasn't been made at all, but she's showing that she is just one of the best, if not the best, outside hitter in the nation.
Samantha Bricio is our ESPNW National Player of the Year, certainly a candidate, as is Dolly Santana. We'll show you the numbers of the two conference players of the year. 25 kills for Dolly Santana. She's hitting 435, 12 digs, so it's her 21st double-double of the year, her ninth match with 20 kills or higher. Meantime, Taylor, 23 kills to complement 9 digs, and she's hitting 228.
So both of these players have really elevated their play as the match has gone on, and really they're putting the offensive load on their back. I mean, they're having to take a lot of swings. Both of their attacks are very, very high. Your legs start to get tired at this point, but you can't let that phase you because you know that your team needs you.
Both of the stars with their ninth 20 kill or more match in the 2015 campaign as Wilhite serves it. Back set to Taylor. Golden Gophers are trying to surge their way to Omaha.
And the swing short just again for Nikki Taylor. She's looking for that seam. Everybody knows that the ball is going to her. But now Minnesota up 3.
To Maglio, side out, Rainbow Wahine.
I like the decision by Taylor Higgins to recognize that Nikki Taylor, last two swings were in the tape. All right, Maglio, let's see what you got. And despite the fact that there's a double block, she goes off of the high hand, setting up an opportunity for Hawaii to stay in the match. Anderson back to serve for the Rainbows, number four. Both benches on their feet as they've been pretty much the entirety of the match. Fans have been up and down, seated right now. That will bring them back up to their feet. Match point, Santana with a crushing blow.
There's no answer for this, and there's barely any words to describe it. Right down the line,
explosive
match point.
To mind. Dominant, electric, incredible. Match point for the two seed, Minnesota. Santana off the blockers. Set outside to Manu Olevao. The Golden Gophers are heading to Omaha.
Minnesota has not strayed away from what they have been all season long, and that's a great, disciplined, balanced team that has a go-to hitter in Dolly Santana that can put an entire team on her back if it's necessary, and they needed every bit of her performance here tonight with that double-double. But an excited Big Ten champion, the coach of the year from the Big Ten is here, the player of the year from the Big Ten is here, and now the Minnesota Gophers are going to take all of that pride, all of that discipline, and all of that offensive prowess to Omaha and see if they can continue playing for a national title.
Two Big Ten teams now in the regional, or excuse me, the national semifinals, fourth national semifinal for Minnesota. They will join Nebraska there, and we will send two more to Omaha tonight on ESPNU. So Minnesota defeats unseeded Hawaii. What an incredible season for the Rainbow Wahine. They finish 29-2, the Big West champions, ran into the Big Ten champs, and they're heading home as the Golden Gophers are moving on into the national semifinals. Look at the smiles on the faces as we send it back to the studio. Minnesota, the victors now.